Welcome back to our intermediate financial accounting class. In our last few segments, we've been talking about inventory, all sorts of fun things with inventory. Basket purchases, lower of cost or market adjustments. We've talked about the retail inventory method and done a simple example of the first of those methods. And we've talked about the gross profit method and how to use it quickly and easily as the simple method for estimating ending inventory. Then I asked you to do two more calculations before coming back, and hopefully you did them. What I asked you to do was to go through this table and figure out the ending inventory value using the lower of cost or market and the FIFO method. We did the average cost together, so hopefully you tried it. Let's take a look at the values and see how you did. So first off, we have our lower of cost or market approach. Here, we use the cost of goods available for sale. We divide by goods available for sale after markups, which we circled on our table. You see it there in blue, 2,051,304. And we see it here again, 251,304. If I divide that, I get 53.6%. I take the ending inventory at retail times that 53.6%, and there's my ending inventory at the lower of cost or market estimate. And you'll notice that number is much smaller than the number we got last time. Here we got 152,542 under the average cost method. Well, lower of cost or market, I'm assuming that it had gone obsolete. I'd had to do a write down, so my ending inventory should be lower. If you look down here, cost of goods sold was 947. It's 965, much higher under this other method. So hopefully you got that number and feel comfortable with the process. The other method I asked you to look at was the FIFO method. Under the FIFO method, again, we're using these same numbers as we did for average cost, except I'm taking out beginning inventory because I assume under FIFO, the beginning inventory is gone. I sold it first. It wouldn't be part of ending inventory at all. So why use it in computing the ratio? So I take my cost of goods available for sale minus my beginning inventory at cost. That gives me this 985. I take my goods available for sale at retail. I take out the beginning inventory at retail. That gives me that 1.631904. I divide that, I get 60.4. Really similar to what we saw in our average cost because beginning inventory wasn't a huge piece of what we were doing. Again, I take the 251,304. That's the size of my dollar. Ending inventory at retail, I could sell this stuff for 251,304. I multiply it by 60%. And that's going to get me from the full amount down to just the portion that's my cost, and the rest of it would be my profit. And so there's that 151,787, and then you can see my cost of goods sold calculation there at the bottom. Hopefully you got it and you feel comfortable with these numbers. Again, the whole point of this is to take the bill, what we would charge to our customers, and break the piece that's our profit from the part that's our cost. And what we did with that whole big thing in step one, this whole piece, was to figure out that the value, the total amount I could charge to my customers was 251,304, and I'm gonna use a percentage to figure out this piece of that retail value. All right, last thing we need to talk about here is LIFO. And LIFO is a little bit more exciting than the other methods, which is why I wanted us to do it together, because I enjoy doing the most exciting stuff. And the LIFO method's gonna be different depending on whether we increase or decrease in value. So let's start with a LIFO increase, because that's what we have here. So what we're gonna do first thing with LIFO, if that's the method that we're using to track our inventory, is we're gonna take our ending inventory at retail, which was the 251,304, and we're gonna compare that with our beginning inventory at retail, which was 179,400. And I'm looking here to see if it's a positive number, then I added a LIFO layer, meaning I added to my inventory. I've had all this stuff that's in beginning inventory. I didn't sell any of the beginning, and I even added some stuff that I purchased this time. You might remember us in earlier examples, if you watched them, talking about ice cream scoops with LIFO, specifically with dollar value LIFO. What we're saying here is we had 179 from previous purchases. Now we're at 251.3. So we want to figure out the size of this ice cream scoop, and our new layer. And we're going to be careful. This is at retail, because I'm using retail values up here. So the size of that ice cream scoop up here at retail is 71,904. Now this is really important. If we do this calculation and we realize that we've added a layer, then we do one thing with LIFO. If we get here and we found out that, you know, it's not 251, it's only this much. This piece has been eaten, and that didn't get added at all, so all of this is gone. If I just have this much ice cream left, that's called liquidating a layer, and we'll do a different calculation for that in a minute. So again, we're assuming right now that the ice cream grew and that we added retail value this period, 71,904. Now that we know that, I take the new layer times the FIFO ratio. And if you remember the FIFO ratio, that was cost of goods available for sale minus beginning inventory. Goods available for sale at retail minus beginning inventory at retail. And it gave us 60.4%. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the 71,904 times that 60.4%, and that's going to give me a new layer at cost. You know, I need to stop right here. I've got my numbers mixed up, so let's make sure I mark this right. So figuring out this ratio, since I won't really have done FIFO if I know I'm doing LIFO, this is step two right here, and this calculation down here, this is step three, and my value comes out to 43,430. What I'm doing is I'm just looking for the value, let's go back up here, of this ice cream scoop. I know that the retail value of the ice cream scoop, the new layer, is 71,904. Just like I've done before, I'm going to break it down into the cost versus the profit piece. And the cost piece is 43,430. Now, why do I do this? Because I already know what the cost was of beginning inventory. I know the cost of these earlier two scoops. I already know it because I have it. It's in my table. Let's go back. Beginning inventory at cost is right here, 115,000. I don't need to recalculate that or estimate it. I know it. So if I take that 115,000, that's the cost value of my old ice cream scoops, and I add the cost value of that new ice cream scoop, well, I've got my ending inventory value. So let's go back. The 43,430, that's my new ice cream scoop. I had 115 worth of ice cream at cost before, and now I've got ending inventory at 158,430. That's my value. And we could go on, we won't take time for it because we're going a little bit long, but we could go on and figure out cost of goods sold just like we've done in the past. That's what we do when we add a new layer. Again, we're just looking at the new scoops of ice cream. And if we were to do this drawing again, what we're saying is these earlier scoops of ice cream, they were 115. I've added a new scoop of 43,430. So my total is 158,430. And I can compare that with the retail values up above. The 158,430 relates to the 251.3. The 115 relates to the 179. The last thing we need to talk about with LIFO is, well, what happens if we don't add a layer? What if we eat some of the ice cream? How does that change our calculation? Let's assume that our ending inventory at retail didn't come out to 251, it came out to 100,000. Step one, I get my ending inventory at retail. And we're going to assume this time it's 100,000 instead of the 251, just so we can show how this works. Beginning inventory 179. And what we see is we don't have a new layer. What we have is that we ate some of the old layer, because we have a negative value. Now, we stop right there. This is LIFO. If I've got less on hand now than I started the period with, then it means that I sold everything I bought this period, because I would have sold it first under LIFO. And then I started selling some of the stuff I began with. So that means that whatever's left in ending inventory is from beginning inventory. Remember when we did our tables and we had all the purchase dates and we had a number of units, and then we figured out a cost per unit. And it was different for each time. And we said when we sell under FIFO, we sell down. So we sell the beginning first, and then we sell the next purchase, and the next purchase, and the next purchase. Under LIFO, we go the other way. We sell this stuff first, and then we get up, and we finally get to beginning. So what we're saying is, we got rid of all this stuff, and we even got rid of part of that stuff. So how do I figure out what's left and what the value is? Well, I need a new special ratio. My cost to retail ratio needs to focus on beginning inventory, because that's all that's left. So I would take my beginning inventory at cost, divided by my beginning inventory at retail. Beginning inventory at cost, if we go back, is this 115. Beginning inventory at retail is this 179,400. So that's what I'm going to use in my calculations. So 115,000 divided by 179,400, and that's going to give me 64.1%. So again, what we're looking at, again, I'm going to draw one of my dorky little ice cream cones. We started with 115,000, that's cost, or 179,400, that's retail, cost, retail. And we've eaten some of it. 79,000, gone, eaten. So what's left? Well, that's what I'm trying to figure out. I know that the retail value is 100,000, because that's what we assumed up here. But I got to figure out what this number is. So what do I do? Well, I take the 100,000. This is the same as what we've done before. 100,000, that's my value at retail, times my percentage. So the value of my ice cream that's left from the beginning of the period is 64,100. I haven't added a new scoop on top. I've eaten away some of the scoops that are already there. What I've got left is 64,100 at cost, 100,000 at retail. And that's how the LIFO method works. Isn't that fun? This stuff is so cool. There's a lot that goes into it, but once you get the hang of it and you see the logic, hopefully it really makes sense. Now again, we've talked about a lot of stuff with inventory, but all of it really important. We're just adding on to what you already know about LIFO, FIFO weighted average, and looking at some of the other things that go on. What happens if things wear out? What happens if I make a basket purchase? What if, for whatever reason, I can't or won't be able to do a physical count of my inventory? Well, here are some methods that we can use. And with that, we get to finish our discussion of cost of goods sold and inventory and move on to our discussion of some of our operating expenses. More fun stuff to come. I'll see you then. Thanks.